الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We resume our lessons in the fundamentals of jurisprudence. This is the 16th lesson, inshallah. And we start at the definition of consensus and verifying its proof. وصلنا في شرح ورقات إمام الحرمين الإمام الجويني رحمه الله إلى باب تعريف الإجماع وبيان حجته، وهذا هو الدرس السادس عشر من دروس علم أصول الفقه.
أما الإجماع
means consensus in English. Probably consensus. إجماع العلماء الفقهاء، وهو ثالث الأدلة الشرعية. الإجماع or general consensus is the third source of legitimate proofs. ثالث الأدلة الشرعية، وقلنا أن أول الأدلة الشرعية هو كتاب الله عز وجل وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم، والإجماع ثالثها، ثم القياس الرابع. هذه ما اتفق عليها كل العلماء، وهناك مصادر أخرى اختلف فيها. So this scholarly consensus is one of four sources of legitimate proofs in Islam that is agreed upon by all scholars, and there are other sources that scholars differ in its legitimacy being as a source of legitimate proofs. فالإجماع لغة له معنيان. And scholarly consensus, linguistically speaking, has two definitions. One of them is al-azm, determination. Determination means determination. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, in the Quran, he said, فَأَجْمِعُوا أَمْرَكُمْ ثُمَّأْتُوا صَفَّا. أَجْمِعُوا أَمْرَكُمْ ثُمَّأْتُوا صَفَّا. Then determine your decision and then come in one as one man. أجمعوا أمركم. أجمعوا means determine, make a determination. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث: لا صيام لمن لم يجمع النية من الليل. لا صيام لمن لم يجمع النية من الليل. There is no fasting, or the fasting is invalid for someone who did not make the intention at night before the day that he is intending to fast. في رواية لمن لم يبيت النية، وفي رواية لمن لم يجمع النية. يجمع من هي determine is to determine. فتقول أجمعت على الأمر، أو أجمع الناس على أمر ما. You know, people have made consensus between, they agreed upon something, they agreed upon doing something. وثاني المعنيين هو الاتفاق. هذا في التعريف الذي في المثال الذي قلناه مؤخرا، ان اجمع القوم على فعل كذا. The second meaning is to agree. So the first meaning is to determine, and the second is to agree. اجمع القوم على فعل شيء. People have agreed to do something. Agreed to do something. وهذا هو المعنى الذي نعنيه في هذا الباب. And this is the meaning that we are concerned with in this section. In this section. والإجماع عندما نقول إجماع اتفاق كل العلماء. When we say scholarly consensus, we mean that the consensus of all scholars, not the majority of scholars, not the majority of scholars, ليس أغلبية العلماء, وليس واحد منهم, وليس اثنان, وليس ثلاثة وكذا. Not only one scholar or two scholars or three, not the majority of scholars, but we mean all of them. If one of them disagreed, then there is no consensus. If one of the scholars disagrees, then there will be no consensus. We cannot call that consensus. وهو اتفاق علماء أهل العصر. اتفاق disagreement between the scholars is always based on proofs. Not like we agree just because we like to agree with one another. But we agree based on what we have of proofs after we searched, after we studied, and after we compared, and then we make an agreement based on that. So this agreement is based on proofs, not baseless. It's not because Abu Salem, I like Abu Salem, and he agreed to something, so I agree also because I like Abu Salem. Not that. Based on knowledge. Based on اتفاق علماء أهل العصر. And العلماء should be the ones who are specialized in this field. Not علماء of نحو, for example. When we say scholars, we mean the scholars who specialize in the fiqh, in jurisprudence. Not the scholars, for example, of language, or scholars of mathematics, or scholars of chemistry, or scholars of physics, right? When we say the scholarly agreement, we mean the scholars that are specialized in the shara, in the fiqh. And that's why they said, نعرف العلماء الفقهاء. الفقهاء, the jurisprudents. Those are the ones we mean that they have consensus to agree upon something. نعرف العلماء الفقهاء. وعلماء أهل العصر قال العلماء أن هذا لا ينطبق على عصر الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن في عصر الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الرسول موجود ولو أجمع غيره على أمر وخالفهم فكلامه هو الحجة وليس كلام العلماء. They said this is not applicable at the time of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم because رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم existed at that time and if all the scholars that live at the time of رسول الله agreed upon something and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم disagreed then what we take is the saying of رسول الله and not the other علماء. This is one way the علماء said but في هذا الكلام نظر. في هذا الكلام قال العلماء أن في هذا الكلام نظر. They said this is not exactly 100% true because رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in many ahadith he said for example لا تجتمع أمتي على ضلالة. In one hadith for example and in other many hadiths with different words all point to the meaning that the ummah of رسول الله will not gather upon misguidance. If the scholars agreed upon something, that must be guidance. So there will be never conflict between Rasulullah and the scholars of Islam. But there's no conflict. Because Rasulullah said that. He said that, you know, my ummah will never decide on misguidance. If they gather, they will always come up with the right decision, the guided decision. That is تَجْتَمِعُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى ضَلَالَةٍ وَالْإِجْمَاعُ الْمُعْتَبَرُ هُوَ إِجْمَاعُ عُلَمَاءِ أَهْلِ الْإِسْلَامِ. consensus that we consider to be valid is the consensus of Islamic scholars of the Ummah of Rasulullah. So the consensus of other scholars from other religions is not considered. Is not considered with us to be valid. So the only the consensus of the scholars of Islam is the one which we consider to be valid. Other than them, there are no other consensus. فهو اتفاق علماء أهل العصر على حكم الحادثة. And this is the consensus of scholars upon a certain jurisprudent case. مسألة فقهية مثلا, مسألة فقهية, we have a jurisprudent case that علماء did not find a text about it in the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah. So they strived to find a ruling for that case. They studied the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah and they made ijtihad. They made ijtihad. And only the mujtahideen are allowed to do that. Not everyone. And mujtahideen are the ones who are allowed to do that. And that's why he said, اتفاق علماء أهل العصر على حكم الحادثة. And then الشارح explained and said, فلا يعتبر وفاق العوام لهم. He said that ordinary people are not included in that. When we mean consensus, we mean the consensus of the scholars, not the consensus of people who are not knowledgeable. The consensus of people that are not knowledgeable is not considered. And this is Imam Al-Juwaynis' status and Imam Jalaluddin Al-Mahalli and other scholars. Some scholars said it, we might consider the consensus of other people other than scholars in cases that are well known, that don't need, you know, much research and much to be meticulous, not the meticulous cases, but the very famous general cases. But most of our ulama said that the consensus should be should come from the mujtahideen, the one that reached the degree of ijtihad, the ones that are very knowledgeable are the ones whose consensus we are considered. And when he said علماء أهل العصر هذه إضافة, نحن قلنا أن الإضافات هذه تعني ماذا؟ العموم. For example, when we say عباد الله, when we say عباد الله, you know, the servants of Allah, we don't mean a certain group of people, right? We mean all the servants of Allah that are obedient to Allah. So the same here, when we say علماء العصر, هذا للاستغراق, قالوا الإضافة هذه, this wording, الصيغة, صيغة عموم. علماء العصر, the scholars of the time. The scholars of the time means we all the scholars of the time. We're not excluding even one, all of them, the scholars of the time. اتفاق علماء العصر على حكم الحادثة. ونعني بالعلماء الفقهاء. And we said that we mean by scholars the ones who are knowledgeable in jurisprudence, because they are the ones who are concerned in searching and finding rulings of jurisprudent cases. ونعني بالحادثة. الحادثة ونعني بالحادثة الحادثة الشرعية. And we mean by the حادثة or by the case is the legitimate case, لأنها محل نظر للفقهاء. Because that case is the one that scholars look into finding a ruling for. And this is what we mean by الحادثة. وإجماع هذه الأمة حجة. إجماع هذه الأمة حجة. And they said that the consensus or the scholarly consensus of this Ummah is an authoritative proof. Is an authoritative proof. So this is يعني حجة, strong evidence that we base our decision upon. Because رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تجتمع أمتي على ضلالة. That my ummah will never agree to a misguidance. Whenever they agree, they will agree on guidance, on a right decision. And many hadiths have this wording. For example, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تجتمع أمتي على الخطأ. My ummah will never gather upon mistake. ما رآه المسلمون حسنا فهو حسن. Whatever the Muslims see as good, it is then good. And he said also, يد الله مع الجماعة. The hand of Allah is with the majority, with the جماعة, with all the group of our Muslims. So سألت ربي أن لا تجتمع أمتي على ضلالة فأعطانيه. And Rasulullah said, I asked Allah, I asked my Lord, that my ummah should never gather upon misguidance, and he granted me that. He answered my dua, and he granted me that. And he said, لم يكن الله ليجمع أمتي على الضلالة. That he said, Allah will never gather my ummah upon misguidance.
You saw that.
There's an echo. Right? There's like an echo. Hand in the microphone. What's doing? Okay. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من خرج من الجماعة قيد شبر فقد خلع رفقة الإسلام عن عنقه. Whosoever goes away from the Jama'ah, leaves the Jama'ah, leaves the majority of Muslims, if he leaves them, then he as if he went out of Islam. As if he went out of Islam. ومن شد شد في النار. And whosoever is يعني did that, then he would be in the fire of hell والعياذ بالله. May Allah forbid. So these hadith, all of them point to the same meaning with different wordings, but all they point to the same meaning, and they strengthen one another. They strengthen one another, these hadith, and these hadith are mashhoor hadith. These are mashhoor, these are famous hadiths, even though they are ahad hadiths. But they are ahad in terms of the chain of narrators. You know, the one or two Sahabi have narrated that. But they are mutawatir in terms of the meaning. Their meaning is mutawatir. هذه الأحاديث متواترة معنى. رغم أنها أحاد إذا نظرنا إلى سندها. ولكنها متواترة معنى. بلغت يعني درجة التواتر المعنوي. وهي حديث مشهورة سندا. Authentic hadith. And ulama, based on this hadith, they see that consensus is an authoritative proof. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, if we look at the ayah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غير سبيل المؤمنين نوله ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساءت مصيرا. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, whosoever strives against Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, as it follows the way that is not of Muslims, then Allah سبحانه وتعالى warns that he will be in the fire of hell. ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين. So معناها اتباع سبيل المؤمنين is the way to go. The following of the جماعة of the مؤمنين is the way to go. Sticking to the جماعة is the way to go. Other than that, it is not allowed. And there's a warning for those who go out of إجماع and they refuse the إجماع and they follow their own whims and desires and leave the جماعة of the Islam, of the Muslims. So الإجماع له أدلة من كتاب الله ومن سنة رسول الله والإجماع إذن ماذا حجة an authoritative source of ruling الإجماع okay وأين وصلنا
شرعه ولد بعصمة الأمة والإجماع حجة على العصر الثاني في أي عصر كان ولا يشترط في حجيته
والشرع ورد لعصمة هذه الأمة Now, as we said, this ummah will never make a mistake if they all gather on something, decide on something, that would be the correct thing to do. And it's not that they will gather to make a mistake, never, never. So this ummah is invalid.
Essentially, ulama is coming together, they decide the same essential or not?
Yes, وفي كل عصر. في كل عصر and in all times if علماء of that time gathered and they made a decision on a case then this is إجماع منهم من قصر الإجماع على عصر الصحابة some علماء said no إجماع is not available now and it's not accessible but what we consider is the consensus of the companions of Rasulullah ﷺ only. But this is not true. The majority of ulama said no, ijma' can be done in any time, as long as all of the ulama agree. For example, this time we have ulama, right? We have ulama. They gather together in one place and they have a legitimate case to search for, and they all studied the case. And got together and discussed the case, and then they came up with decision. All of the ulama. If that happens,
they know each other.
Yes, they know each other.
All of the what?
Yes.
They have called each other and meeting somewhere.
Exactly.
And come in.
Meeting somewhere, and they have searched the case, and they have decided. If that happens, then that's ijma'. And whosoever comes after them cannot invalidate this ijma'. Ijma' will stay. All the time. So, ولهذا وقال والإجماع حجة على العصر الثاني meaning the time after رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وفي أي عصر كان and in any time and in any time as we said now الإجماع is valid as long as all of the scholars agree then this is consensus then this is consensus في أي عصر كان الإمام جلالدين سيد عصر الصحابة ومن بعدهم whether it is the time of companions of Rasulullah or the time that comes after them عصر التابعين وتابع التابعين وبعدهم إلى يومنا هذا إلى يومنا until this day نعم
ولا يشترط في حجيته انقراض العصر فإن هن انقراض العصر الشرط يعتبر قوله
لا ولا يشترط في حجيته انقراض العصر and it is not a condition that for the إجماع to be valid that all of the scholars that made the إجماع have passed away after they agreed upon something so if the علماء of all the scholars agreed upon something and they all passed away after agreement. They say this is not a condition. Their passing away after the agreement is not a condition to make the ijma' valid. The ijma' is valid in that way. Whether they stayed alive or whether all of them have passed away. فلا يشترطوا انقراض العصر في حجية الإجماع. So this is not a condition, but there is a difference of opinion. Some ulama said Imam Al-Juwayni is a Shafi'i, he's following the school of thought of Shafi'i. Al-Hanabila ishtaratu inqirad al-asr. Those are the ones who follow the school of thought of Imam Ahmad ibn Muhammad rahimahullah. They said this is a condition. They should all be passed away after they have made the decision. Just to make sure that they all agreed and nobody of them after that changed his mind. لم يغير أحدهم رأيهم بعد الإجماع. الحنابلة اشترطوا ذلك. Once we follow the school of Father Ahmad Muhammad, they made this as a condition. But the Kufaro Imam Shafi'i رحمه الله, they said that no, this is not a condition. ومنهم الإمام الجويني, الإمام الجويني شافعي المذهب. الإمام الجويني follows the school of thought of Imam Shafi'i رحمه الله. ومعظم العلماء على أن انقراض العصر ليس شرطا. Majority of scholars, they say that passing away of all scholars after they have made the decision is not a condition to make the ijma' valid. And this is not a condition. ولا يشترط في حجيته انقراض العصر بأن يموت أهله على الصحيح. على الصحيح. يعني موت أهل الإجماع في عصر معين لأن الأدلة التي ثبت بها الإجماع حجة لم تدل على هذا الشرط. They said there are no evidence to consider this as a condition for إجماع to be valid. For example, you said, yeah, follow. فإذا قلنا انقرض العصر
العصر شرط تعتبر قول من ولد في حياته وتفقه وصار من أهل الاجتهاد وهم على هذا القول أن يرجعوا عن ذلك الحكم.
Yes. So they said if علماء who made the إجماع at that time someone was born and he grew up and he reached the level of being mujtahid, of ijtihad. He reached the level of being mujtahid. And he, for example, if he agrees, you know, to the opinion of the scholars who made the consensus, then that will strengthen their consensus. If he was disagreeing with that consensus, then they have to go back on their decision. Because now there is another scholar that didn't agree with them, right? But the other ulama said, no. The ijma' once made, it cannot be invalidated. They said, if ijma' of all the scholars has already been made, it cannot be invalidated. And those ulama who made the ijma' cannot go back on their decision. Cannot go back on their decision. So this there's this opinion and there's this opinion. There's two opinions about that. فإن اتفاقهم هذا يكون حجة ولا دليل على اشتراط حجية الإجماع بموت المجمعين. They said there is no evidence that the إجماع has been validated because the scholars who made it have passed away. No, there's no evidence that this is a condition to do.
والإجماع يصح بقولهم وبفعلهم وبقول البعض وبفعل البعض ومشابه ذلك القول والفعل الباقين عليه.
نعم. They said that consensus is valid whether they said that, made a statement. And all of them, they made a statement that the ruling of so and so case is this. Whether they said it in a statement by their tongues, or whether they did that, I would be fair. Whether they did it by saying or did it by action, ijma' in this case is valid. Is valid. أن يقولوا بجواز شيء أو يفعلوه فيدل فعلهم له على جوازه لعصمتهم كما تقدم. He said if they said something or did something. And all of the scholars agreed to that, then this is valid. Then this is valid. ولكن يعني علماء said usually the doing is preceded by discussions between them. And they would have agreed verbally with each other to do that action. So the action is actually preceded by saying. So doing by action is not taken as separate. Because before you do action, ulama would have discussed this amongst them And they have must have agreed verbally before they applied it. So القول هو المعتبر, the sayings are the ones who are considered. Every action is preceded by sayings. The actions are not done just arbitrarily. فالإجماع يصح بقولهم وبفعلهم. ويقول البعض وبقول البعض وفعل البعض وانتشار ذلك القول أو الفعل صح وسقوط الباقين عنه. And they said, but if some of them agree, some of the ulama agree, okay? And there are other ulama who were not present, but they heard of that decision, and that decision was only made by few scholars, but all of the other scholars heard it, and they remained silent. They didn't say that this is valid or this is invalid. So some ulama consider that as consensus, and they call it al-ijma'u al-sukuti, the silent consensus, meaning that ulama heard about that decision, but they did not deny it, they did not reject it, nor did they agree to it, so they just remained silent. So that silence is taken as agreement. That silence is taken as an agreement. يسمون هذا الإجماع السكوتي, the silent scholarly consensus. The silent scholarly consensus.
نعم. وقول الواحد من الصحابة ليس
هذا خلاص كلش. نرجعه إن شاء الله إلى الدرس القادم. فقال العلماء إذا كان السكوت للموافقة وليس لخوف أو مهابة أو لم يعلم الساكتون بالحكم. They said this silent scholarly consensus is valid if that silence is taken as an agreement. For example, suppose that some ulama remain silent because they fear, because of fear. They have, concern that if they say agree to it, they might, be harmed, for example. Or suppose that there are ulama who didn't even hear about the decision. So these cases can happen, right? So in that case, they say that is ma'sukuti, not valid. So if the silence of some scholars is out of fear, for example, or out of lack of knowledge of that decision, then that wouldn't be considered consensus, general consensus, because not all of the ulama agreed upon that. They might disagree, but they are afraid to say. Know what I mean? Said that in that case, that is ma'is, is not valid. I think so this is about the session where the Imam al-Haramain is talking about the ijma'. Any questions?